Welcome to Getting Started with Zoom and Kahoot for Virtual Trivia Programs, brought to you by the Halton Hills Public Library. This will be a quick how-to guide for accessing and using Zoom and Kahoot as part of our virtual trivia programs. This presentation will show you the ins and outs of how to access and play virtual trivia with HHPL. For trivia programs, we use two separate programs, Zoom and Kahoot. As many of you already know, Zoom is a virtual meeting program where participants can see and talk to one another. This is an important part of the social aspect of trivia. Additionally, Zoom will allow you to see all the trivia questions and answers. Kahoot, on the other hand, may be new to some of you. Kahoot is a quiz program that allows users to answer questions using a device. This is how you answer the trivia questions. Kahoot then automatically scores each player based on how quickly they choose the correct answer. Incorrect answers are automatically scored as zero. First, let's look at what devices you need in order to participate. In order to see the questions and answers, along with the hosts and participants, you need access to Zoom using a computer or a laptop. Once the host starts screen sharing the Kahoot, a larger screen makes it easier to see and read the questions and answers. Also, it is often easier to type in the Zoom chat using a standard keyboard. Additionally, you will also need a device or a second computer in order to participate in the Kahoot quiz. Devices such as tablets or mobile phones work best because they're small and easy to maneuver around. Kahoot works on both Apple and Android devices. Although we are using Zoom for virtual trivia programs, this tutorial is not going to go into depth on how to use it. If you need help on how to access Zoom, please check out our tech video, Getting Started with Zoom, on our YouTube channel under the Tech Support playlist. The most important thing you need to know is that a staff member will email you with the Zoom link and meeting information, either the day before or the day of the program. This is how you enter the Zoom meeting. Once you have entered the Zoom meeting, you will automatically be muted. This is because depending on the number of people, it could get really loud really quickly. Plus, we want to make sure that everyone can hear the host, as they will be the ones giving the instructions. Instead, we encourage participants to use the chat function to talk with others during the program. When ready, the host will begin screen sharing the Kahoot. This means that participants will now be able to see the trivia quiz on their screen and hear the host's voice. At the top of the Kahoot waiting room, participants will see the Kahoot pin. This is the number you will need to enter on your device to access the trivia quiz. There are two different ways you can access the Kahoot on your device. The first is by going to your tablet or mobile phone's browser and typing in kahoot.it into the address bar. This will bring up a screen for you to enter the pin and start playing. Alternatively, you can download the Kahoot app onto your device. Either way, you join the Kahoot by entering the game pin on your device. Next, you'll be asked to enter your name or a nickname for the game. Just remember to keep it clean, folks. Once you have entered your name, check your Zoom screen where it will show up. If there's a lot of people participating, your name may disappear from the screen after a while, but as long as it was there when you first entered it, you are good to go. Once everybody has joined, the host will start the trivia game. Depending on the type of trivia quiz created, it will either start with the first question, or you will see a slide like this one explaining what round it is. Remember that the screen sharing on Zoom is where you will see the questions and the answers. From here, the first question will begin. It will start with a screen that will let you know what type of question will be asked. Although there could be different types of questions, like true or false, or ranking type questions, most often trivia will have what are called quiz questions, which are multiple choice with four possible answers. On Zoom, the question will first appear as a large banner across the screen. This is when the host will read the question aloud. At the bottom of the screen, there is a timing bar that moves. This is letting you know when the answers will be revealed. It moves very quickly, but it does give you a little time with the question ahead of the answers popping up. While the question first appears on the Zoom screen share, you will notice that your device has a screen that looks like this. It is just letting you know to get ready to answer the question. You will notice that the question itself does not show on your mobile device. It will only show up on the Zoom screen share. After the initial question screen, the Zoom screen will change to look like this. Now you can see the question, what is the goal in the game of Red Rover, and the four possible answers. Additionally, on this screen, you can see the countdown timer, which shows how much time participants have left to answer the question, and how many people have already answered the question. At the very bottom of the screen, you will see what question you're on, in this case, the first of 8 questions, and the game pin. This is important because if for some reason you accidentally leave the game, or if someone wants to join in late, you can still access the game using the pin. Once the answers come up on the Zoom screen, your device screen will also change. You will see the 4 color shape combinations that match the answers on the Zoom screen. Participants will select by touching the color or shape that matches the correct answer from the Zoom screen. You will also see on your device the question number, again showing us question 1 of 8, as well as your name and score appear on the bottom. In this case, Thor has a score of 0, because this is the first question, so there really isn't any score yet. Once all participants answer the question, or the timer has run out, Kahoot has an answer chart. This tells the participant which answer was the correct one, as well as the breakdown of how all the participants answered the question. The next Zoom screen shows the current leaderboard. Kahoot will show the top 5 scores in the game, as well as noting anyone who might be on a current streak of correct answers. This pattern of questions, answers, and leaderboard will continue until the game is complete. At the end, Kahoot will show the top 3 teams, bronze, silver, and gold. We know that with any type of technology, some difficulties may occur. Here are a few ways that we might be able to help you with your virtual trivia experience. Check the settings on your device or computer. Things like connectivity issues, firewalls, as well as JavaScripts and cookies may interfere with using Kahoot properly. Look at your permission settings. You may have restrictions set up that won't allow Kahoot to run properly. Test your volume settings. If you're having trouble hearing the host, you may need to turn up your volume or take your computer off of mute. If there are issues with Zoom on your computer, try changing to another web browser. Sometimes certain programs don't play nicely with certain web browsers. We have often had success with using Chrome. We have discovered that some smaller monitors often have similar resolution and pixels to mobile devices. If this is the case, you may have some difficulty with seeing the questions and answers. Although this is not something we can fix on our end, you can still play by listening to the questions and answers read by the host. You can reach out to us in the Zoom chat function. If it's something we can help you with, we will certainly try. Alternatively, you can reach out to us by email before or after the program through askus@haltonhills.ca. Please try to be as specific as possible so we can help you. Both Zoom and Kahoot have wonderful support on their websites, along with videos and webinars that can assist you visually. If you need some help on a topic that wasn't covered here, they may have one available for you. Thank you for joining us for getting started with Zoom and Kahoot for virtual trivia programs. I hope you were able to learn something new. Remember to enjoy this and many other free programs available to you with your Halton Hills Public Library card.